Hi everyone. Today we're going to be propagating amaryllis via chipping. There's lots of cool ways that you can propagate amaryllis. You can propagate them via seed, which we did together last year. We pollinated a pink surprise amaryllis. We grew the seeds on, and here's what they look like about 9 months later. You can also propagate an amaryllis via offsets, which we've done in the past together also. So you have a nice large mother bulb, and you might see a little bulb start to form here near the basal plate. That's called an offset, a bulblet, or a daughter bulb. And basically you can just snap that off, pot it up, and it will eventually grow into a big mother bulb and flower. However, not all amaryllis cultivars produce a large amount of offsets. And so if you fall in love with a certain variety, say for instance, Magical Touch, and you want tons of bulbs for not a lot of money, and that variety doesn't produce a lot of offsets naturally, then doing a method called chipping is really useful. And you can chip any kind of bulb. All we're really going to be doing today is cutting into the basal plate of the bulb, halfway down into the bulb itself. And then what's going to happen is that we'll plant it into pre-moistened vermiculite. And over time, the mother will produce a lot of offsets from all of these cuts that we made. But what will also happen is that she will pass away. She will sacrifice herself to make all these daughters for us. With that being said, if you have a really valuable amaryllis and you only have one of them, I would not recommend chipping that variety. I like to chip varieties where I have a couple of them and I really like them, but they're just not producing a lot of offsets. That's when I use chipping. So let's go ahead and do this fun and easy process together. So here's the amaryllis that we're going to be chipping today. This is a mature double dragon amaryllis. You can see it's already started to produce an offset for us, so we'll remove that before chipping it. But in order to go ahead and chip this bulb, I want to go ahead and get rid of all this soil, cut most of the roots off, and also peel off these old scales, these old papery scales I want to get rid of. I'll go ahead and just remove this offset right now. So that's a daughter bulb. I'll continue to clean this one. I'm going to go ahead and remove most of the roots now. That'll make it easier to clean it. Now I'll just remove the outer papery scales. We've got the bulb clean. The roots are trimmed down. The basal plate is intact. Now what I'm going to go ahead and do is sterilize my knife, put on some gloves, and we'll start to cut into this bulb. So I sterilized my knife and rubbing alcohol. I've got my gloves on, clean cutting board, clean pot, everything really, really clean. Now what I want to do is basically I'm going to cut the nose off. This isn't totally necessary. It just makes it easier to then cut into the basal plate. So let's see how I can hold this so you can see it like this maybe. So now what I'm going to do is make pie-like cuts into this bulb. I want to cut about halfway into the bulb, making sure I get the entire basal plate in each cut. So you can kind of see how deep I'm going. The basal plate actually goes down into the bulb a little bit. Now I'm going to make that cut again from this direction. There's the second cut. Now I'm going to cut it two more times. So now we've cut the bulb into eight different sections, and to prevent it from growing back together, because it will try to do that, you want to place something in between the cuts. I prefer to use some kind of plastic versus introducing organic matter. So I just have these zip ties. Once again, these have never been used before. Nice and clean. And just insert them into your cuts. So that's what it looks like now. Once again, these are only here to prevent the bulb growing back together. We want the bulb to produce offsets, not grow back together. If you don't have vermiculite around, you can certainly use perlite. the way I learned was to use vermiculite, but I'll link a bunch of different studies below so you can decide the best medium for you. So there we go, some nice pre-moistened vermiculite. Now we've got our pre-moistened vermiculite. All we're gonna do is stick the bulb right into that vermiculite. Roots down, cuts down, and we'll bury it just like you would a regular amaryllis bulb, leaving just a little bit of the top exposed. Go ahead and give it a bit of water. Not necessarily to water the bulb, but just so that the medium is moist. I'm gonna go ahead and label this pot with today's date and also the cultivar, because when you do chipping, they will come true to the parent plant. This is a clone of the parent that we're creating. Now what I'll go ahead and do is stick this on a radiator. You could also use a heat mat if you prefer. Bottom heat is gonna speed up this entire process. It's not totally necessary, but if you have bottom heat, I would definitely recommend using it. Now that we have our chipped amaryllis on the heat, I'll just make sure to keep the vermiculite lightly moist at all times. And I'll do update videos about every 3 months. 3 months from now will take us into March. At that point, we should be able to see some leaves emerging. 3 months later is going to take us to June. We should be able to put the pot outside to grow much faster. And then 3 months from that point, we can transfer them from vermiculite into potting soil. And also at that point, the mother will probably have completely disappeared. And lastly, friends, I wanted to let you know that I'm going to provide a link to the International Society of Horticultural Sciences below. That is a really wonderful website. It's easy to search and you can find lots of studies from people over in Korea, South Africa, Israel, from the big bulb producers about the latest studies in science on amaryllis propagation. It's always changing, and things that they were doing, say even 30 years ago, they're now almost disproving or advising against. Things like incubation or the correct amount of cuts for the highest yield and the biggest bulbs. So it's really a nerdy rabbit hole you can go down if you're really interested in bulb production. Well, I want to wish you a wonderful day out there in your gardens, and I'll see you for an update on this project in about 3 months and lots more gardening soon. Bye.